Good afternoon, friends. My name is Dr. Mayur Pai, and I am an infertility specialist in Goa in India. Today, I am going to speak on IUI. IUI is one of the most basic infertility treatments offered to many. So let us go into some details.
And friends, do see the video right till the end, where I am going to speak on a bonus feature, that is donor sperms, donor IUI, and the different modern techniques which are used to avoid donor sperms. These are those treatments which can help you achieve a pregnancy in which you can be the father of your own child. That means even with low sperm count, you can be the father of your own child.
In case you are new to the channel, I welcome you all. Kindly subscribe to our channel and press the bell notification button so that you receive notifications for all our future videos. What is IUI? IUI is a type of fertility treatment in which the woman is inseminated with sperms of high quality. By high quality, we mean that the sperms are usually of high sperm count, sperm motility, and very good sperm morphology. The sperms may be husband sperm or donor sperms, as the case may be, and as the couple has decided. Which patients benefit from IUI treatment? Now, IUI treatment is not for everyone. However, IUI can be done in most cases of male factor infertility, like low sperm count, also called oligozoospermia, poor sperm motility, also called asthenozoospermia, poor sperm morphology, also called teratospermia, and all of them can be occurring in a combination in a single patient, and there it is called OAT. O standing for oligo, A standing for asteno, T standing for terato. IUI may often be used in cases of female infertility. Some of these cases are polycystic ovaries and anovulatory infertility. Often in cases of polycystic ovary and anovulatory infertility, the problem is that the woman is not able to produce her eggs or follicles in good quantity or quality. These women are often given treatments like ovulation induction and superovulation to make sure that they produce good number of eggs. These treatments can often be combined with IUI to yield better results. Female factors like endometriosis and adenomyosis may also benefit from IUI treatment. Unexplained infertility. This type of fertility problem means that the reason for the infertility is unexplained or unknown. Women with a single functioning fallopian tube, where the fallopian tube is either diseased or blocked or has been surgically removed. IUI treatment can often be done in couples having difficulty in intercourse. For example, males having an abnormal shape and size of the penis, or in females who have an abnormally sensitive or tight vaginal introitus. What are the prerequisites for IUI treatment? As mentioned earlier, IUI treatment is not for everyone, and certain prerequisites have to be satisfied on the part of the husband and the wife in order to undergo a successful IUI treatment. In the male or the husband, the sperm count should be at least 20 million. That means that IUI starts suffering for sperm counts less than 20 million. So if the sperm count is 15 million, 5 million and 10 million, IUI may start giving less than optimum results. For IUI treatment, the sperm motility should be more than 30 to 50%. There should be adequate sperm morphology, and the male should have the capacity to ejaculate into a jar or a sperm collection bottle. There are certain prerequisites for IUI treatment for the wife as well. She should be able to produce her follicles or eggs, and she should have at least one functional fallopian tube. Now let us see how IUI treatment takes place. IUI treatment usually begins on the 2nd to 3rd day of the wife's menses. The lady presents to the hospital, where she undergoes transvaginal ultrasound. In the transvaginal ultrasound, we look for what is called the antral follicle count, that is the number of eggs in the right and left ovaries. We also look for other things like cysts or other tumors which may hamper her progress in the IUI cycle. Once we find out that the lady has no cysts or tumors inside her ovaries and she can safely undergo the egg stimulation process, we begin it on the same day. Depending on a case-to-case basis, we either give them tablets or gonadotropin injections or a combination of both. Either ways, this leads to the production of eggs called follicles. The eggs are small to begin with on the day 2, day 3. As the follicles progress, they increase in size by around day 7, day 8, and approximately on day 10 to 12, they reach what is called the 18 mm size. The 18 mm size is also called mature follicle. When the follicle is matured, we give an injection called a trigger, which is usually HCG, 10,000 international units. This injection causes the release of the eggs from the follicle. Which is used for fertilization process inside her fallopian tubes. On the day of IUI, the husband gives his sperm sample in a wide mouth sperm collection jar by the method of masturbation. If for whatever reason the husband is unable to give his sample by means of masturbation, then he is also allowed to use a sterile condom to collect his sample by means of vaginal intercourse. By either of these methods, if the husband is in a position to give his sperm sample, then this sample is then sent to the andrology lab, where it is processed into a 0.5 ml concentrate which contains the healthy motile sperms. These healthy motile sperms are then loaded onto an injection and these are directly injected into the center of the uterine cavity with the help of the IUI method. Once these sperms enter the uterine cavity, they go into either of the fallopian tubes and here they interact with the wife's egg to cause fertilization. So this is in short how IUI process works. Now let us talk about some of the frequently asked questions on the topic of IUI treatment. We are often asked questions like, is IUI painful or is IUI uncomfortable? The truth is IUI treatment seems to be a very complicated treatment, however it is not. IUI is one of the most simple and basic treatments in infertility and is highly convenient to the patient as well as the doctor. 90% of the patients coming for IUI do not have any complaints to do with IUI. They do not feel any form of pain or discomfort during the entire process of IUI. However, it is important to note that in about 10% of the cases, the women may experience mild uterine cramping, which is similar to the uterine cramping noticed by women at the time of their monthly periods. Also, it is important to know that the pain and discomfort during IUI process itself is similar to transvaginal ultrasonography, like you must have done during your ovulation studies, or any gynecological examination like a per speculum or a per vaginal examination which you might have undergone with your routine gynecologist. Also, it is very important to note that some women are really sensitive or may be having a painful vaginal introitus. In very sensitive women, IUI can still be very comfortably done under general anesthesia. This sort of a general anesthesia, which is given to IUI patients, is a ultra short acting anesthesia given using injection propofol and sevoflurane gas, and it just lasts for a few minutes so that the patient is very comfortable during the IUI process. Also, it is important for you to note that the anesthesia safety is very high and there is a very small chance of any untoward complication in this sort of an anesthesia. Let us discuss another frequently asked question in IUI treatment. What precautions to take after IUI treatment? It is important to note that we do not recommend strict bed rest after IUI treatment. However, if the lady is in a position to take bed rest for 3 to 5 days after IUI treatment, she can do so. The lady is advised to take plenty of water and fluids, regular medications as prescribed by the fertility doctor. She should avoid heavy work, hard work, jogging, running, or high impact exercises. We recommend high protein diet. In case the lady consumes non-veg food, we recommend her to have boiled eggs with the yolk removed. That is, she can take only the egg white, maybe 2 to 3 egg whites per day, every day. If the lady is a strict vegetarian, we recommend her to eat badams or almonds. We strongly recommend to avoid papaya, caffeine and caffeinated drinks, tea, smoking and alcohol. Now we come to a very important slide which you can see on your screen. These are those questions which are frequently asked by almost all patients of IUI and fertility treatment. They always want to know what is the success and also what is the cost associated with it. So I am covering all these questions at once. What is the success rate of IUI treatment and what are your chances of success after IUI treatment? So, if tablets are used to grow the wife's eggs like clomiphene citrate or latrozole and the husband's sperms are inseminated using IUI technique, then we can expect a 5-7% success rate in the couple, which means that out of every 100 couples who undergo IUI treatment using tablets, we can expect 5-7 of the couples to succeed and achieve a pregnancy. Also, if injectables like gonadotropins are used to grow the wife's eggs, that is during superovulation protocol, and if IUI is done to inseminate her with the husband's sperm, then we can expect a 15-20% success rate in the couples. That means out of every 100 couples, 15-20 couples would succeed in a single cycle. Another important question which I would like to answer on the same slide as mentioned before is the cost of IUI treatment. IUI treatment cost depends on how the IUI is being done. When IUI treatment is combined with tablets for ovulation induction like clomiphene citrate or latrozole, then we can expect a cost per cycle of 15,000-20,000 rupees. Whereas when IUI treatment is combined with superovulation protocol using injectables, then we can assume a cost of 20,000-30,000 rupees per cycle. So on this slide, you have the complete information as far as the cost and the benefit, that is the success per cycle for the couple. Another very important question which we will answer about IUI treatment is on your slide on the screen. How many IUI treatments are necessary for a pregnancy? For couples with a high fertility, 1-2 cycles may be enough to have a pregnancy. However, for a couple with medium fertility, maybe 3-4 cycles are necessary. Whereas for couples with low fertility, even 6-8 cycles of IUI treatment may be necessary. at this stage, it is very important for the couple to understand that there is no specific test or group of tests which can be done in you to quantify your couple's fertility as low, medium and high. The slide is just for your basic understanding, and different diseases can be graded as mild, moderate and severe. However, from this slide, a very important message that you should take is the last one. If the couple is not able to conceive after 6 to 8 superovulated IUI cycles, then it is necessary to reassess the case, maybe re-establish a diagnosis and or consider IVF as a means forward. It is at this stage that your doctor may recommend laparoscopic or hysteroscopic surgeries or any other investigation to reassess the diagnosis in the couple. Also, IVF is a great way forward in case the IUIs have failed for at least 6 to 8 cycles. Now, let us look into the advantages and disadvantages of IUI treatment. IUI treatment is a very easy and convenient treatment both to the patient as well as the doctor. IUI does not require the patient to undergo anesthesia. There are very few investigations required before doing IUI, as well as for the doctor, the setup is fairly modest. Also, IUI treatment has a way lower cost as compared to IVF treatment. Also, it is very important for you to note that IUI treatment is successful in many couples when the reports are good. So, we recommend that IUI treatment be done in couples in whom the reports are normal and who have failed several timed intercourse treatments. So, what are the disadvantages of IUI treatment? IUI treatment has a much lower fertility rate as compared to IVF treatment. IUI success rates may be challenging in difficult cases like that of resistant polycystic ovaries, when the age of the woman is more than 40 years, if she has a single functional fallopian tube, or there is low sperm parameter in the husband, like extremely low sperm count, less than 20 million as I had shown in the previous slides, low motility and poor morphology. Remember, IUI starts suffering when the parameters are very low, and we recommend treatments like IVF plus ICSI in these cases. You can see several other videos on the topic of low sperm count and ICSI on our videos on this channel. Also, another issue with IUI is that several cycles may be necessary in some cases. So now, we are coming to the bonus topic of the day, that is donor IUI and donor sperms. So, what is donor IUI? IUI done using donor sperms is simply called donor IUI. We recommend that IUI with donor sperms be done only after proper consents, counseling and paperwork. Also, IUI with donor sperms should be done in a clinic with great experience with handling donor IUIs and which has the due permissions for the procedure. Now, where does donor sperm come from? Donor sperms normally come from certified donor banks, which are also called ART banks. It is important to note that the donor identity is never revealed by the sperm bank. So, what is revealed? Information, vital information about the donor sperm, such as the fact that it is fully tested for diseases like HIV, hepatitis B and C and other sexually transmitted diseases, the hair color, eye color, skin color of the donor, the educational level of the donor, and another vital information, that is the blood group of the donor, is always revealed by the sperm bank. So, when are donor sperms used and when is donor IUI recommended? Donor IUI is mostly recommended in cases where the husband in the couple is HIV, hepatitis B or C positive, whereas the wife is negative for these diseases. This is done in order to prevent the spread of HIV, hepatitis B or C into the wife. If there is azoospermia in the husband, that means there is no sperm found in the testes. At this point, it is necessary for you to note that there are two types of azoospermias. Azoospermia may be in a case where the sperms are produced by the testes, but the sperms are not released out into the seminal plasma. Also, another type of azoospermia is called non-obstructive azoospermia, in which the testes fails to produce sperms. We recommend donor sperms to be used in those cases of non-obstructive azoospermia where no sperms are produced in the testes to begin with. It is important for you to note that there are very good treatments for obstructive azoospermia. In these treatments, we can extract the husband's sperms from either the testes or the epididymis and use it for conception in techniques of IVF and ICSI. You can see further videos on treatments of azoospermia on our channel. Donor sperms are also recommended in cases of genetic abnormalities in the husband. That means that the abnormality is so severe that it should not be passed down to his children, or the abnormality is such that he cannot conceive to begin with. Another important factor for donor sperm use is very poor sperm parameters in the husband, which is also combined with low budget for the couple for IVF. This is a very common issue which is often dealt with in couples who require IVF for low sperm count and the budget is not good enough for that. Often, IVF with ICSI is the treatment of choice in couples who have low sperm count. However, this costs somewhere close to 1.5 to 2 lakh Indian rupees. But it is very important for you to understand that not always will that IVF work in a single attempt. At times, the counts are so low that 2 to 3 attempts may also be required in the couple for a proper conception. This has to be declared by the IVF team to the couple right before doing the process. Internationally, IVF success rates have been 30 to 40% only, not more than that per cycle. So there are couples who do not want to take a chance with their budget or cannot afford to go ahead with the IVF ICSI cycles. These are the perfect couples in whom donor IUI can give a ray of hope. Donor sperms are also recommended in single women who want to become a parent.
So now we are coming to the last slide and our last bonus topic for the day, in which I will tell you how, in spite of low sperm count, low sperm motility or morphology, you can be a father, a genetic father of your own child. Very often we get males who have very poor sperm count, very poor sperm motility and very poor morphology. However, in these people, if we at all screen their sample and process it thoroughly, we may find very large number of healthy sperms. But these sperms are not enough to perform an IUI or allow them a natural conception.
This is when we recommend intracytoplasmic sperm injection, also popularly called as ICSI. On this slide on your screen, we can show you a very brief idea of how ICSI is performed. For the process of ICSI, we require the wife's egg, which is extracted by the process of IVF. At the same time, the husband gives his semen sample in a wide mouth container by process of masturbation. At the same time, if at all the husband is not in a position to give the sample by masturbation, he may use a sterile condom to give us the ejaculatory fluid. In certain cases of obstructive azoospermia, the same sperm sample can be extracted either from the epididymis using procedures called TISA or PISA, or directly from the testes using micro TC technique. You can see the TISA, PISA and micro TC techniques in further details on our videos on the topic in our channel. Once the sperm sample has been obtained, we segregate and process out the unhealthy immotile sperms or sperms with low morphology, and we only extract the healthy motile sperms from the sample. These healthy sperm samples, which have been obtained from the husband, are then micro injected into the egg using a micro injection needle. All this thing happens below a microscope which is called an inverted microscope. This process is called ICSI. After the process of ICSI, what we get is embryos which are kept on the petri plate to mature between 3 to 5 days. Then these matured embryos are then transferred into the wife's uterus through the IVF process in order to achieve pregnancy. So this is how, in spite of a low sperm count and low sperm parameters, you can achieve a pregnancy with your own sperms. I hope you have liked today's video. If you have, please press the like button. Please do remember to subscribe to our channel for more informational videos on laparoscopy, infertility and their treatments. My name is Dr. Mayur Pai and it was a great pleasure bringing you this episode. If you have any comments on today's videos, then kindly comment in the comment section below. If you want to discuss your case with call or WhatsApp, my number is there on the screen below. Until next time, see you.